I moved to LA 5 years ago, next month, I believe. And yeah, so I got like 2 years before the pandemic, and then yeah, it was well and truly stuck there through COVID, and yeah, just hit my fifth year. It's cool. Not what I planned at all. But sometimes the best things aren't, you know? So I'm glad I'm in LA.
Yeah, it seems to be working out. Mm-hmm. I mean, I know you're a big fan of football, you know, soccer. Mm-hmm. Have you found a community in LA of people you can watch games with?
Absolutely. I watch games with people, mainly play a lot of football, soccer. I found a similar group of unfit British musicians who we play in teams with. So yeah, found people at my level, which is great.
Every now and then I fall. Every now and then I lose control. But in your eyes I see your thoughts around me, and I've a little bit of thought for you. Cause every now and then I fall a bit behind. Every time I stare into your eyes, it's every now and then I fall a bit behind. Every time I stare into your eyes, with your thrills I find it's not hard to be left behind. So I'll run and you'll hide. We know better than to stay outside. You're cold and you're awake. You said I should never stay, but there's no better place for me. Cause every now and then I fall a bit behind. Every time I stare into your eyes, it's every now and then I fall a bit behind. Every time I stare into your eyes. Every time I stare into your eyes, it's every now and then I fall a bit behind. Every time I stare into your eyes, every time I stare into your eyes, every time I stare into your eyes. Every time I stare into your eyes. Every time I stare into your eyes.
So, yeah, my last record was called Grand Plan. And when I wrote the album, I knew that usually when you complete an album and you start thinking about production and recording and stuff like that, you tend to think about just like a professional producer, which is what I've done in the past. But I felt that with this album of demos that I had, I wanted a musician to produce it. You know, someone who was an artist in their own right and had their own music and their own passion projects and stuff like that. And so I started looking around for a lot of musicians that I really looked up to, and they also did production work on the side and stuff like that. And one of the guys who I was absolutely loving at that time was a guy called Matthew E. White, fantastic musician, fantastic producer. And I asked him if he wanted to produce that last album, and he was really into it. And so I didn't actually know where he was based. And so when he said Richmond, Virginia, I was just a bit like, I don't really know where Richmond, Virginia is. My geography wasn't great, but, and I don't know what I expected as well. I think I was probably a little bit snobbish coming from a big city like LA and all of these big studios and people like that. But the Richmond music scene is absolutely incredible. And it was a big surprise to find out when I turned up that he had a record label, management company, actual studios called Space Bomb, and just that whole scene of Space Bomb and what all the artists are doing and the management are doing and the publishing are doing is incredible. It's like, I've been back there a lot and kind of can't get enough of it.
All on the bed and all across the floor, packing my bags and I'm headed for the door. All the lights are fading out, they won't be back again. I'm taking a lap and saying my goodbyes. I'm kissing the cat with a tear in my eyes. All the lights are fading out, I won't be back again. No hard feelings, no regrets, no passing blame or late night texts. We'll run us up out of frame. Still, I'm so proud of how close we came. How close we came. How close. My exit, I'm gazing to the side. He left me a note and it caught me by surprise. All the words were ringing out, we won't be seen again. Sun through the window, LA at its best. The birds that attacked me still laughing from their nest. All the songs are singing out, but won't be heard again. No hard feelings, no regrets, no passing blame or late night texts. We're runners up out of frame. Still, I'm so proud of how close we came. How close we came. How close. Got a new place and it's looking real nice. Location is great, but it comes at a price. Living all alone again, money's come and gone. I'm starting again, I'm washing out the stains. I'm getting it together, grabbing hold of the reins. Hope it's not been too long, moments come and gone. No hard feelings, no regrets, no passing blame or late night texts. We're runners up out of frame. Still, I'm so proud of how close we came. How close we came. How close. How close we came. How close. we came, how close we came, how close we came.
Yeah, I think I'm on my fourth album now, fifth album? I can't even remember, but I'm well into the game now. And those first two albums, the way that I was writing songs, the way that I was recording songs, it was all this layering and layering and layering, and it was kind of drowning out the original core song or core message and stuff like that. And whenever it came to playing those songs live, it felt so awkward and it didn't feel natural because I didn't feel like the songs could stand on their own two feet without those elements of production or those extra band members or things like that. And so with the last record, Grand Plan, I only allowed myself one instrument and vocals. That was it. I bought a four-track cassette machine. And so all I could have on these four tracks was a lead vocal, a guitar or a keyboard, and two backing vocals, and that was it. And so it meant no matter what production we did in the studio, no matter what we added on top of it, I knew that I could come all the way back and still play it on my own. And so since the last record, I've definitely found the love for performing again, because I don't feel awkward playing these kind of hodgepodge songs. Now it's kind of back to basics in a way. Take it all the way back, write a song from start to finish on one instrument, commit to it.
Spinning signs on boulevards and putting faith in tarot cards. You've been a valet, a taxi on the way late at night. Grab a glass and raise it. How does it feel? Does it seem surreal? 'Cause when all seemed faded, you joined the 1% that made it. How does it feel? Does it seem surreal? So surreal. Waiting tables, men in bars, pressing sheets and washing cars. People come and gone, told you you're the one every time. Oh, look at that, you've made it. Now grab a glass and raise it. How does it feel? Does it seem surreal? 'Cause when all seem faded, join the 1% that made it. How does it feel? Does it seem surreal? So surreal. And I'm glad, so glad that you made it. So glad, so glad. And raise it. How does it feel? Does it seem surreal? 'Cause when all seemed faded, you joined the 1% that made it. Oh, how does it feel? Does it seem surreal? So surreal.
I mean, had a bit of a weird life, but in a kind of nutshell, up until I was about 18, I was playing rugby to quite a high level. I know I don't really look like a rugby player, but that was like my life. That's all I wanted to be, was a rugby player. And then that ended with a kind of horrific injury that ended that career. And so I kind of recovered from this injury amongst a couple of instruments, my sister's piano, my mum's old kind of like classical nylon guitar. And so over that kind of year of recovery, I started playing a lot of music and kind of getting into it and kind of started thinking like maybe this could be a career. And I started applying for universities around that time. And so there was a couple of universities that I really wanted to go to. One in particular, which was in Liverpool, which was kind of where I was brought up. It was called the Liverpool Institute for Performing Arts. And I was like, so tough to get into. And I'm so new to music. You know, these other people have been like writing music since they were like 4 years old and stuff like that. I'm like an 18-year-old who's just quit rugby trying to write a song. It sounded terrible. And so, yeah, but I was like really driven to do it. And my dad, who's an absolute sweetheart, he's a very, very supportive man. And he kind of, I guess, as like a way to motivate me to get into this university and like really give it my all, was to kind of dangle the carrot on the stick kind of thing. And I think in our like local guitar shop, I'd played a Taylor guitar and kind of just like, just loved it. It was obviously a very high quality guitar. And considering all I'd ever played before was like my mum's beat up classical guitar, it was like a world apart. And so my dad, who definitely didn't have the money for a Taylor guitar at that time, said that if I got into this university, he'd buy me a Taylor guitar. And so I did. And he, true to his word, yeah, he bought me a Taylor guitar. I can't remember. For some reason, 315 is in my head, like 315E, maybe that, something
that
like
that.
That
sounds right, yeah. 314,
yeah, no, I mean, cherished that guitar ever since. You know, it's
been still have it?
Yeah, yeah, still got it back home. Yeah,
very
yeah.
Cool. And now you're playing a 717. How are you liking the 717 these days?
Yeah, it's been lovely. I mean, I haven't played my, because I've obviously moved over here, I haven't played a Taylor in a long time, but it's beautiful, kind of rich, bright sound. It's very nice, very smooth neck to play. I like to kind of go up and down. It's great.
I hear your life is feeling pretty dull. You want something satisfying that'll make it fun. You want to change, but your mom and dad don't want to ever see you escape the norm. Stuck in a city, unable to travel. You want your head to unravel and feel the loosening of the change. You feel society is placed on the path that chose ahead of you. So you take a bad boy home to see. If he makes you feel special, maybe gives you that self-belief. Yeah, you take a bad boy home to see. If he makes you feel special, makes you feel like a rebel in need. Streetlights, late nights, he wants to take you for a ride on his motorbike. You finally got the chance to feel alive and let go tonight. He watches James Dean on movie screens, smokes straight, wears leather and tight jeans. He's a man that you need in your dreams when you're sleeping tonight. So you take a bad boy home to see. If he makes you feel special, maybe gives you that self-belief. Yeah, you take a bad boy home to see. If he makes you feel special, makes you feel like a rebel indeed. Pick yourself up, dust yourself off. Take the time to realize it never works out. Pick yourself up, wipe the tears dry. Try to find the confidence you're holding inside. Pick yourself up, dust yourself off. Take the time to realize it never works out. Pick yourself up, wipe the tears dry. Try to find the confidence you're holding inside. So you take a bad boy home to see. If he makes you feel special, maybe gives you that self-belief. Yeah, you take a bad boy home to see. gravy makes you feel special, makes you feel like a rebel in need.